Good morning, all of you. Please mute yourself. Now, the national level workshop is going to start. Good morning, once again. Dr. Veeramani, sir. Good morning. Please mute yourself. Dr. Veeramani, sir, are you
here? Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Okay, thank you, sir. So, principal, sir, is also here. So, once again, good morning, all of you. Welcome you in the...
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir. Good morning.
Thank you, sir.
So welcome you in the virtual platform of Srimati Radhadevi Goenka College for Women, Akola, Maharashtra. My deepest salutation to the founder president, late Mataji, Srimati Radhadevi Ji Goenka, president of BSS, that is Bhartiya Seva Sadan and Institutional Innovation Council, Honorable Dilip Raji Goenka, sir. Honorable Principal Dr. Devendra Ji Vyas, sir, Honorable Vice Principal and Head Department of Commerce, Dr. Ambadas Ji Pandey, sir, Honorable Resource Person of today's National Level Workshop, Honorable and respected Dr. S. Veeramani, sir, all the participants, faculty members, research scholar and students. Just one minute. So, on behalf of Institutions Innovation Cell and Department of Commerce of Srimati Radhadevi Goenka College for Women, Akola, Maharashtra, I, Dr. Rupa Gupta, welcome you in National Level Workshop on Entrepreneurship and Innovation as a Career Opportunity. As it is the urge of time and situation to become our own entrepreneur and innovative. By considering these things, our college has organized this national level workshop. So without getting much more time, let's do the Sri Ganesha of this program. Vakratunda Mahakaya Surya Koti Samaprabha Nirvignam Kurume Deva Sarvakareshu Sarvada. My salutation to Lord Ganesha. With his blessing, we are going to listen the golden words of Dr. Veeramani, sir. So, honorable, our principal, Dr. Devendra Ji Vyas, sir, is always motivating us to conduct and organize such type of events for the betterment of faculty member and students. So, as today, sir, is not available because he is out of station. So he conveyed his best wishes for us. Simultaneously, it is my humble request, the vice principal of our college, Dr. Ambadas Ji Pandey, sir, please convey your message or address us on this occasion. Over to you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Good morning. Good morning, sir. Good morning, sir. Good morning. And good morning.
Yes, good morning, sir.
All of you. My deepest salutation to our founder president, Shraddhaya Mataji, late Srimati Radhadevi Ji Goenka, president of Bharatiya Seva Sadan and his institutions, Innovation Council, Honorable Dilip Babuji Goenka, our principal, respected Devendra Ji Vyas, sir, all the participants, faculty members, research scholars, and dear students. Good morning, all of you. Today, we all are living in the era of innovation and creativity. Everyone appreciates and likes innovative practices. Rather, I would say it's a demand of time and current scenario. If one has innovative and creative ideas, definitely one can move ahead on the path of success. Dear students, if we channelize our energy and efforts, we can easily achieve our goal. If you are a student, I would like to say, don't restrict yourself in a boundaries, because you should become job giver or rather job seekers. Create job opportunities for yourself and others also. Those who will present and give unique themes and ideas can survive in this world. As the mission statement of our college is empowerment. Empowerment of women through economic independence for the betterment of students. Sir, as being women college, we have set our mission, empowerment. With this noble intention, our college has also opened incubation, innovation, and research center. Our president, Honorable Dilip Babuji Goenka, is himself president of this center, council. The main aim behind the establishment of this council is to do something new, to do something useful for our students, to save, SHAP, I would like to say, to save their career in this competitive era without taking much time. Actually, I am also eager to listen to today's knowledgeable and renowned person, the best speaker, respected dear Manish sir. Sir, with this, I wish all the best to the participants. Thank you very much. And Dr. Virmani sir, I'm very much thankful for sparing your valuable time for our students and all participants. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for your golden words. Now I request Sonam Shukla from Department of Self-Learning. Please introduce today's resource person, Honorable Dr. V. Ramani, sir. Over to you, Sonam.
Good morning to one and all. There, am I audible?
Yes.
Yes, you audible. Audible.
Yes, you audible.
Okay. So I'll start. There are some people who don't need to be introduced by special words because they are special in their own way, in their own style, and their uniqueness makes them special. And it's our pleasure that that special person is with us today in this workshop. Here, I want to address one beautiful quote. What we say is important. For in most cases, the mouth speaks what the heart is full of. So the person who is directly going to speak with his heart is present here. And I, Sonam Shukla, from Department of Self-Learning, from Srimati Radhadevi Goenka College for Women's Akola, on behalf of everyone present here, feel extremely honored to introduce resource person and today's speaker of this workshop. The guest of honor, Dr. S. Viramani sir, head and assistant professor of English, research advisor from Government Arts and Science College, Lalgudi, Tiruchirappalli. So now tell me one thing, do you all know why he is here today? I want answers from everyone. Do you all know why he is here today?
Yes,
to make you feel bored.
Yes, obviously you all must be aware about this. But I'll tell you everything about him and give you the reason for why our ears will be blessed by listening him. Dr. S. Viramani, sir, is an illustrious alumnus of St. Joseph's College, Tiruchirappalli, Tamil Nadu. He received a PhD in English from St. Joseph College. He has acquired 12 years of teaching experience. Since 2017, he has been working at Government Arts College Kulithalai Karur district, where he was also a nimble coordinator of IQAC, NIRF, and soft skills. He has published research articles in various international and national journals. He has completed 20 online courses from MOCs, and to his credit, he has published 3 books. He has been zestful resource person for almost 60 academic events organized by various institutions across the state. He acts as reviewer, editor, and member in professional bodies. He is proud recipient of 4 awards that are: first, Kanavu Nayagam Abdul Kalam Award; second, Sangha Thamizhar Award; third, the Best Faculty Award; and fourth, the Best Research Paper Publisher Award. He is also a member of Board of Studies in English in University of Mumbai. He is an expert in outcomes-based education. He is a member English Board of Studies with special expertise with outcomes-based education. So today, he is here to enhance us, tell us how to recognize opportunities, how entrepreneurship and innovation can be used as a career opportunity. And this is the topic in which we should all be deeply interested, because I am damn sure that this will definitely work as keynote in our future. So hereby, I request S. Viramani sir to please share his golden thoughts with us. Thank you. Over to you, sir.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. At the outset, I have to thank the college management, principal sir, and vice principal sir, and Dr. Rupa Gupta, and other faculty members and students, and other participants. A special thanks to Dr. Rupa Gupta, because she has given a wonderful opportunity to attend the refresher course conducted by your college along with the institutions, the government institution. And again, she has given an opportunity to share my thoughts and views about the innovations and entrepreneurial development.
Sir, sorry for interrupting, but your voice is not clear.
Is my voice audible to you?
Yeah, right now, sometimes it's breaking, it's not clear.
It's not clear.
Yeah, now okay. You can continue, sir. Sorry for interrupting you.
Yeah, it's okay. No problem. Yeah, so I have to thank and each and everyone here, those who have joined virtually to have some knowledge about the entrepreneurship and the innovation. Yes, now I would like to share my screen.
Sir, again, your voice waned. You are not audible to us.
Okay, please wait for some time. Sir is sharing screen.
Okay, ma'am.
Is my voice audible? It should be. Is my voice audible to you right now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you very much, my dear friends, for your reciprocation. I have taken my points and the concepts which I am going to deliver from these books. Okay, from these books only I have taken the points for this particular topic given by Dr. Rupa Gupta. Yes, these are the sources. These are the sources I have consulted. Okay, I have consulted to give my inputs on the particular topic. Yes, it will be useful for you. Yes, and then I straight away I go to the my presentation today. This is the title itself says that there is a difference between entrepreneur and entrepreneurship. First of all, the title is Entrepreneurship and Innovation as a Career Opportunity. So in the 21st scenario, in the digital academic 21st scenario, we people are finding jobs as well as we can have a number of opportunities, a number of opportunities to give the job, and it's like a job provider to others. Okay, it's like a job provider to others. So like that it is there. So in this case, I would like to I would like to tell you a few things which are very, very important to all the students and other faculty members and so on. So from the beginning itself, what I'll tell you is Clarence Danhoff has divided entrepreneurship into four groups. The number one is innovating entrepreneurs. Innovating entrepreneurs in the sense they create the new idea to execute their own job creation. Okay, job creation, and also they wanted to involve in the job. Okay, it's very difficult today. So whether you are getting into the job or else you are creating job or else you are providing job. But what I tell you, when you create jobs and you can provide jobs to others rather than seeking for the jobs, no? So you can provide and you can create jobs and you will be the job providers in the job market. So this is the concept. So that's why this man, Danhoff, has classified into four groups. Number one is innovative entrepreneurs. Innovative entrepreneurs in the sense they know how to read the psychology of the buyer. Okay, they know the psychology of the buyer, and then he is mingled with the assemblage of information and analysis of results. Okay, and then he has created something new in the job market. It is the objective of this particular innovative entrepreneurs is to develop the economic situation in a country. So this is the first point. And then the second point, that is adaptive or imitative entrepreneur. So adaptive or imitative entrepreneur in the sense, you know, that on the very title itself, we can understand, adopt the concepts. Okay, we can adopt the concepts from others. At the same time, we can copy and we can make use of that the suitable innovations along with the technology and your skills to develop your entrepreneurial skills and so on. So this is the second point. And the third one is you find that the Fabian entrepreneur. In this Fabian entrepreneur, you find that they are all lazy and they do not want to change. Okay, like that. And and then the drone entrepreneur, they do not want to copy or use the opportunity that come on the way. Okay, that will come on their way. But they won't make use of that kind of opportunity. But they simply, what they do is, it is given to them, they do, that's all. Then business entrepreneurs, it's a kind of a small business entrepreneurs, we can say that. And then the trading entrepreneur, we find the product in markets, in manufacturing, and then industrial entrepreneur. I have classified some of the entrepreneurs. Okay, corporate entrepreneur, agricultural entrepreneur. Some people today say that agriculture is waste. And do you give importance to the agriculture like that? But it is not like that. There is a course called MBA in Agricultural Management. Okay, when you complete that course, MBA in Agricultural Management, you know the business related to the agricultural products and so on. So that's why we have classified the entrepreneur In the classification, we have the agricultural entrepreneur also, and then technical entrepreneur and non-technical entrepreneur. You find the pure entrepreneur is motivated by psychological, economical, and ethical considerations. Okay, and then induced entrepreneur, we find a government that provides assistance. You find no government also provides assistance to buy incubators. Okay, and then they, if the students are willing to do their own business, the government itself is willing to provide loans and so on. So in order to promote that student as an entrepreneur, okay, entrepreneur, that means it is not that a job seeking, but you are making use of the opportunity that will come on your way. That's the first point you have to understand. That is entrepreneur, which means you are making use of the opportunity, and also you are finding the opportunity to make use of your own skills, based on your own skills. Okay, that's the self-fulfillment. And then a novice entrepreneur, at the beginning itself, they can do, but it may be in the failure or in the success and so on. Then serial entrepreneur, then portfolio entrepreneur, first generation entrepreneur, and then we have the modern entrepreneur, women entrepreneurs, nascent entrepreneurs, and habitual entrepreneurs, and the corporate entrepreneurs, and social entrepreneurs. Then you find a number of entrepreneurs. But I have taken only a few entrepreneurs, starting from that innovative entrepreneur. But we, the professors as well as the students must go in for the innovative entrepreneurs. That's what my point, that is your home take point, is the innovative entrepreneur. You must be there. Okay. And then there is a relationship between entrepreneur and entrepreneurship. It's very important. But people think that both are the one and the same. But it is not like that. But entrepreneur is a person. Here you find that. It refers to a person, okay? It refers to a person. And entrepreneurship, the title is entrepreneurship, okay? The entrepreneurship, which means it refers to the process. You find that. It refers to the process, the activity, and the action. So the students must have some sort of process and some sort of activities and some sort of actions. Only then you are able to complete your entrepreneurial skills. Okay, entrepreneurial skills, which are the dynamic one. I tell you that it is not that static. Okay, it's only dynamic. Say for example, leader is the entrepreneur. But what is the entrepreneurship? The entrepreneurship for leader is leadership. So most of the people, most of the successful men, they have the leadership quality, leadership skills. Okay, they should not have that ego, the pride, I am a leader, you should obey, like that. That kind of a thing must be demolished when you are involving in the entrepreneurial skills, or when you are taking the entrepreneurship. Okay, so that's the point. So here the leader, it transforms into leadership qualities. You know that there are so many qualities for leaders. Okay, John C. Maxwell says, I am very much interested in reading the books written by John C. Maxwell. What he says is, a leader should not love his chair. Okay, if I'm sitting on the chair of head of the Department of English, I should not love the chair where I'm sitting, but I have to love the responsibilities given by the chair. Okay, the responsibilities, the process, the activities, the actions given by the chair. So I have to love. So that's the quality of leadership quality. The students must have the leadership quality. You should not say that Even if you have completed this job on your own, you just say that it is a kind of a team spirit. It's a kind of a teamwork like that. If you say, and if you have that kind of a mentality, especially exclusively for the students, I will tell you that there is a leadership quality in you. That's why I quoted that from John C. Maxwell's. Okay. And then planner, you find that planner. Planner is the a person can create, but planning in the sense how to do it. Okay, how to do it and what are the other steps and what are the pros and cons of a particular what should I say, the the business you are going to take up like that. The programmer can be a person, but the action, how you are going to execute the action, okay, the ways, the means and so on. Then motivator, the motivation, how do you motivate? That's the process. That's the entrepreneurship. Okay, so how you sometimes some people are self-motivating. Okay, self-motivating. They think that it's not a problem. I can do it. Even if they fail in their business, they will take it as a challenge. As a challenge, and they will take it as kind of a good lesson and so on. And then risk taking, you find that risk taking is also very important point in the entrepreneurial skill. Okay, then creativity. For this creativity, I'll tell you, my friends, you need to understand, you have to read the mindset of the buyers. First of all, the buyers are your leaders, I'll tell you. If you are involving in a kind of a job or a business, the buyers are your masters. So the buyers, you must read the psychology of the buyer. You must read the psychology of the needs of the buyer. Okay. So in this way, you can have that, the creativity, and then the technology and innovation, the vision. The vision is where it's like an eagle. Your vision should be like an eagle, no? Like an eagle, how the eagle will look at the each and every small objects from the very distance and so on. So like that. So then technology, initiative, organization, decision making, you find that. Then administration, adopting, delegating. Okay, ethics, it's very, very important. It is not only in the entrepreneurship, but also in all kinds of business and all kinds of activities, either it is a formal education or informal education or else the business and so on. The ethics is very, very important, and then skills. Say, for example, Steve Jobs, all of a sudden, he did not create the MP3 players, okay, MP3 players, or else the smartphone. First of all, he has read the needs of the people, the needs of the people. He has read and created the iPhone. Find that. People. So that's why, instead of entrepreneur, the students must have the entrepreneurship skills. Okay, like as I told you earlier, planning and leadership and action and motivating and risk taking, creative vision and goal setting, and then we find imagining and vision. So in the entrepreneurship, you can create your own business. And so a student cannot become an entrepreneur, but he becomes a novice. As I told you earlier, it is a novice entrepreneur. So if he fails, that particular student must analyze his failure, and then he has to redo this by having all the process. Okay, and then economic development and promotion. Promotion in the sense it is for the our nation promotion. the nation's economic development. So these things are very, very important in the entrepreneurial and entrepreneurship. That's why our government, the Indian government, has given number of opportunity for the young entrepreneurs, okay, irrespective of the fields and so on. Yes, now we are living in the knowledge-based society. A knowledge-based society in the sense, what we say, literate or illiterate. Okay. They are able to use of the technology right now. After the COVID-19, it has given one kind of opportunity for each and everybody to learn technology and so on. Yes, it's the revolution. Revolution is a very, very important thing in the knowledge-based society. Okay, and then we find that this revolution can be had through the research to the mission in the sense. For example, now we can take that, we can what should I say, find a person, you ask the person to buy something to have your lunch or brunch or a breakfast or supper like that. Then you will give him some kind of tips, no, or else 10 rupees or 15 or 20 like that you will give. It was a kind of a custom. Nowadays, what you are doing, you are just clicking and you are running to the Uber or else the entrepreneurs to bring your need. I mean, the food that you wanted, okay? The food that you wanted, like that. It's happening. It's happening because that kind of companies, they have read the mindset of the people. That's why they are using the psychology of the people for promoting their own economic wealth and so on. So that's why through the research only, you can promote the revolution. And then revolution made economic and social development. As I told you, it's a kind of a linguistic word. Innovation, academic innovation is a kind of a linguistic word. And some of the universities, they have the paper called academic innovation. Okay, academic innovation. So in this academic innovation, they give a number of skills and number of innovative opportunities and government schemes and so on for the sake of making the entrepreneurship among the students. Okay, and then, that's why I told you that innovative disciplines and programs are continuously conducted by the department or else the universities and so on. And then creation of new teaching techniques. We need to have the person from the industry. That's why there is segment under the NAC purpose, the industrial and institutional relationship. The industrial and the institutional relationship, which means how the industry needs and what are the needs of an industry and what are the requirements that expect from the students. Okay, the students whom we are producing. Okay, the students whom we are producing, whom we are giving the skills and so on. So that's the point. And then that's why in this entrepreneurial skills, especially in the academic innovation, the students must have some kind of knowledge about the society, and then the professors or the trainers or the experts from industry must give some type of skills to the students. They have to instill the skills in the students' minds. Okay, both the things should go neck and neck to achieve the entrepreneurial and entrepreneurship and so on. And then the custom-made educational courses. Custom-made educational courses in the sense it depends on the regional purpose. Okay, it depends on the regional purpose. It depends on the regional purpose. At the same time, what I tell you is a particular region and the people, those who are living in the particular region, they would like to consume some type of products, some type of goods and products and so on. So how you can develop that kind of buying and selling process? So that is the skill, the first of all, that's a skill. That's why I tell you one more point, that is custom-made educational course. Okay, custom-made educational course in the sense, the training should be customized. The consultancy must be customized. The extension activities must be customized. All these things are there. And then the characteristics of entrepreneurial universities. Okay, universities in the sense, not only in the universities, but also institution of, you know, innovative centers like, you know, you have this kind of center. It's a wonderful, beautiful center. Really, you can do more to the students. Okay, you can create more number of entrepreneurs in the society. So when you create the more number of entrepreneurs in the society, automatically the economic development of that particular region is also developed. So that your institution and your students, your entrepreneurs are contributing to the development of the nation. So first of all, it is the objective of the nation, first of all. Okay. And then the organizational units, how the organization has the units and so on. And then stimulated academic heartland. Okay. How the entrepreneurial units are functioning well, and then entrepreneurial culture. How do you create the entrepreneurial culture? Say, for example, if the student is able to create something like a pen or a pencil or else something which is used by the students as well as the professors at their home, they can produce, they can create, and then they can come with that objects created by the students, and then they can get the permission from the principal, they can sell it in the college. Okay, it's a kind of a developing the entrepreneurial skills of the students. Okay, for example, the girl students, they can do the patchwork on the sarees. Okay, they can do the patchworks and they can coloring and so on. So that kind of entrepreneurial skills they can have. So that thing can be utilized in the college or in the institution. So for the college management should encourage the students to develop their own entrepreneurial skills and so on. So the, I mean, after that, if the student is well versed in this, he or she can get the loan from the government, they can develop. Finally, they are providing jobs. Okay, you are not job seekers. Finally, what you do is, your role is, you are job givers. Okay, you are job giving, you are giving the jobs to five or three or six or 10 people, I mean, under your headship and so on. So this is what I tell you. The educational institutions must have the IIC centers. Okay, so in your college, it is there. And in some of the colleges, they have this particular center. Really, I'm very happy about to know that your college has that kind of center and so on. This entrepreneurial culture is integrated with the students and the institution and so on. And then the environmental changes in technology, economy, and social values. Say, for example, in a traditional way of selling things can be revamped, can be rechanged, can be restructured through the use of technology. Okay, through the use of technology and the social values and so on. So if you have the traditional way of selling and traditional way of promoting, it's a kind of lagging behind it. It's a kind of somewhat the lacking sense. Okay, that's why I tell you that it is the technology should be used for your entrepreneurship. technology. It's very important because we people living on the earth cannot stand against the technology, first of all. Okay, we can never stand against the technology. So technology is growing. Technology is going to its highest peak. Okay, so we cannot stand against the technology. So that we can make use of the technology in your entrepreneurial skills and so on, especially the social values. That's why I told you earlier, that is the ethics. Okay, the ethical values must be there. And then what I tell you is the relationship to the industry and the government changes. It's a very important point. The students must be aware of the government's rules and the government policies, how you can do and promote your entrepreneurial skills. Okay, and then the relationship between the government and the industry, you must know that. Okay, it's a kind of a collaboration. So all of a sudden, you yourself cannot do anything else. But if it is a collaboration, that's why we have the very important point, that is interdisciplinary. Interdisciplinary in the sense, your product, how it can be collaborated with the industry. The industry may be something else. Say, for example, medical industry, you know, medical industry, they are treating the people. They have some sort of medicine, but the molecules, that is the chemistry. The chemistry is mingled with the medical field. The physics is mingled with the medical field. Okay. So, and then, say, for example, the healthy economics. Today, we have the another term called healthy economics. How the economy is influencing the health of the person and so on. That's why the relationship to the industry and the government changes must be known to the young entrepreneurs, the young students. That's why I tell you that this particular point. And then that is the university based research, and you find that internal regulations, changing of the internal regulations. See, when you want to take up the a kind of a business, the small business, okay, you have to have the tendency of changing the internal regulations, rewarding and incentives. So when you become, say, for example, if a student becomes a very big, great business magnet from your college, so that he or she knows very well about that, he giving the incentives and rewards and norms of behavior and so on. So it's my duty to tell you about these things when I am talking about the entrepreneurial skills and entrepreneurship and the innovations. You find you must create something new, and then it has to be registered in the patent rights, IPR, intellectual property rights. You know that the students must be aware of IPR, intellectual property rights, and the policies and the laws and the rights which are hidden in the which are written in the IPR. Okay, and then these are all the interlinked for the entrepreneurship. Okay, and then it's the entrepreneurial in transforming their organizational structure. And the extra, and to adapt to the external environment, in the sense, you need to study the regional needs in the sense, the people, those who are living in a particular dialect, okay, in a particular region, okay, in that region, how the people are willing to buy a kind of product or particular product. And why do they like? I just analyze through the research, small research, or else you can give the questionnaire, and then you find a kind of research, and then how that the buying and selling product can be utilized through the technology, the knowledge. Okay, here you find that knowledge economy. You find that knowledge economy is also found here, like that. They also seek to encourage the collective entrepreneurial action at all levels. Okay, that's why I told you that it is to promote the entrepreneurial culture. to develop the entrepreneurial culture, you have the collective entrepreneurial actions. Collective entrepreneurial actions in the sense, I gave you the difference between entrepreneur and entrepreneurship. Okay, under the entrepreneurship, what are the qualities and what are the skills? If you have that skills and if you have that innovative ideas to develop each and every point given under the entrepreneurship, definitely you will become a good entrepreneurship. Okay, you will become a good entrepreneur. Okay, you can provide jobs to other people. Okay, and then it's a kind of entrepreneurial university. You find some universities are there, some foreign countries, they have universities like entrepreneurial universities and academic entrepreneurship, and then university entrepreneurial activities. Under this, you have the consulting firms, teaching services firms. Okay, teaching services firms in the sense, the exclusively when you are learning the entrepreneur's course or entrepreneurship course, okay, total quality management system, okay, TTM, total quality management systems, when you are teaching, especially the instructors and the trainers must go with some innovative ideas, okay, some innovative ideas, not that old one. But if you have that old one, already some people are making use of that, and then they are yearning more and more. So your entrepreneur activity will be in failure like that. That's why I feel and what my suggestion is, the professors, those who are having this paper to handle, must have exclusive skills and different skills and so on. Yes, and then gaining industry support for the university research. Yeah, it's very, very important. Entrepreneurial skills, it is not only for students' business development, but also it is to develop the nation. It is to develop the nation, and it is to you yourself can develop, okay, in the economic level and so on. In the economic level and so on. Yes, thank you. And then, it's you find that it's a large scale science. Actually, for some of the activities, you find that in the academic entrepreneurship, you have the large scale science, and then external teaching. External teaching, that means you invite the instructors or trainers from the industry to teach your students. Okay, but we people are academic, we teach them through the academic point of view. But whereas if the trainers are coming from the industry or business, they know how to deal with the students with the skills. Okay, with the skills, and also they can ask you to obtain the important skills that you have to create your own entrepreneur business and so on. So that's why I tell you that the we can have the teaching, we can have the training from other industries and the I will tell you that the arts people can have the copyright, but for the science people, right? Okay, so copyright thing, if it is an academic innovation, I'm talking about the academic innovation, and then licensing and patenting, incubated systems, and then intellectual property offices are there. You can create that intellectual property offices, and then transfer offices, and then technology licensing offices. Okay, all these offices can have in the academic innovation and so on. Yes, now we can go to this entrepreneurial university and entrepreneurial university. That means you can create the science parks. Already we have in India, there is a science park and so on. technology transfer offices, entrepreneurship education, and exclusively entrepreneurship education. It's very, very important. It is a must one to give much more importance to this particular subject. Okay, because in this 21st century, in this scenario, we find the students are finding very difficult to find a job. Okay, so we can make them create a job. We can make them provide a job. So that's why we can give much more importance to this entrepreneurship education and so on. And then, it's going like that. And then the innovations. Okay, under this topic, we can have that innovations. And then production of high quality students, teaching. The activity is teaching. When you teach, okay, when you teach, when we have the not only the teaching purpose, but also teaching and learning purpose. Okay, teaching and learning both should go neck and neck. Okay, so when we have that teaching and learning process, we have that high quality students. We have to produce the high quality students and establishing the relationship with the practice. Okay, practice of the entrepreneurial skills. And then that's why we can create something new. Only then we can create something new. Otherwise, the innovation will not take place. I tell you today, when the students are having the entrepreneurial skills and the skills of various industries and so on, the students will not have the entrepreneurial skills and they will not be the business people and business successful businessmen. Okay, and then training courses can be conducted. Okay, training courses can be conducted and the traditional programs can be used with the technology. The traditional programs can be used along with the technology and the industry and community members. Actually, industry and community members, in the sense, it is a kind of relationship between the industry and the public. Okay, industry and the public, and how the public needs some goods and products to consume. Okay, the same thing can be involved in this training course. And then this entrepreneurship education. In this entrepreneurship education, we have the producing entrepreneurs and not only the workers. Okay, not only the workers, it's a very, very important point. That is, not only the workers, but also you are going to create the entrepreneurs. Okay, and then publishing. You have the dissemination of knowledge through the scientific articles, books, and after intellectual property rights. Okay, and you can publish the books. When you publish a book, say for example, if you need a kind of a book is very much interested by all the students across the globe. Okay, across the globe or across India or across your state or across your region, across your district, you can write that book and you get the IPR Act. Under the IPR Act, you can have the Copyright Act. Then you have the royalty, or else you can publish a book and then you earn money. This is also kind of entrepreneurship. It is not entrepreneurship, which does not mean that only you are having the small business and so on. Okay, small business and so on. So you have the entrepreneurial skills, even in the very big industry, in a very big business organization also, you have that. Okay, so that's the point. And then patenting. In this patenting, you find that it is it is meant for the science people. Okay, they can create some kind of a patent, and then the patent can be registered in the Patent Right Act and so on. Then licensing, everything is there. And then the community services in the sense, formal advising. You are giving the public lectures. And this particular point is meant for the trainers and the teachers. Okay, and then business creation. The new companies can be created by you through the technology. Okay, the new companies, I tell you, I tell you that since you have the IIC centers, you can have the small business, small scale business, or a small business activity. You can involve in the small scale business activities. See, along with that, you have the technological knowledge and the technological use and so on. Okay, and then you find that the contract research in the sense development of research under public and private contracts, you find that how it can be used to procure money. Actually, say for example, whether I come to work here or you are going to work there, or else you are creating jobs, or you are working in some concerns or business concerns and business firms, for everything to procure money. Everything is to earn money. Okay, that's the ultimate point. I am very, very particular about that, whether you accept it or not. But you need to survive, you know. Everybody needs to survive. Okay, every student or every entrepreneur must survive. For that, money is needed. Money is very, very essential. So along with that money, along with that content, along with that the satisfaction of earning money, what is your contribution to the society? In that point only, you become an entrepreneur. Okay, in that point only, you become an entrepreneur. And in that point only, you develop the nation, you develop the community, you develop the regional the development and so on. So that's why when a person becomes an entrepreneur, okay, he or she has social responsibilities. That's why the entrepreneur is given much priority by the government, and also they are given some type of assistance related to money or manual or manpower and so on. So, or else collaborating with the people. So here we find that science and technology parks we have. As I told you earlier, we have the science and technology parks, we have that. Okay, and then innovation curriculum. So in the curriculum, in the universities, in the colleges, especially in the autonomous colleges, they can change the curriculum. Okay, still they have some of the universities and some of the institutions, the colleges, they have the curriculum which are very, very, what should I say, obsolete. Okay, very, very obsolete, very traditional curriculum. They have that. It has to be revamped and it has to be restructured according to the needs of the people in the region and needs of the people in the nation, in the world, like that. The curriculum design is to be revamped, the restructured. This is my observation, first of all. And then here, when you want to, you know, invent something, okay, invent something, the first point is from how to why. You have to ask this question, how to why. Why do I need to create something new? What are the purpose? Okay. Instead of how we are going to do, how we are going to create. If you have that tendency of how, you cannot create something new. But you say, why do we create? Why? What is the reason? When you say why, and then you find that reasons. Finally, you have something collectively, a kind of a innovative idea. Innovative idea, you have that. And then you find the moving, yes, yeah, you find that moving from how to where, okay, how to where. Where are we going? Where are we going in the sense the region? Either it is to limited one or not, okay? Say, for example, if your destination is for the global one, yeah, you are acknowledged. Your innovative idea is acknowledged. So that's why you have two points which are very, very important to create the innovation in the curriculum. That is from how to why and from how to where. So why and where are very, very important thing to create something new. Yes, the next thing is in the curriculum design, we need to instill the content and the organization. The content and organization in the sense, it is not that simply the organization where the company is running, but the organization of the content according to the series, And then only you have the organizational skills. Okay. Then we need to change the teaching methodologies, the environment and materials. You find that environment, materials, and the materials, no, materials according to the situation, according to the 21st scenario. I'm talking about 21st scenario and so on. And then training the students and the formation of the students from innovation and entrepreneurship. Okay, innovation and entrepreneurship. When you invent something that can be applied for the business, that business definitely will go to the peak. You become an entrepreneur. Okay, when you become an entrepreneur, when you have 5 or 4 more workers at the small level, at the beginning level, at the novice level, you become an entrepreneurship. Okay, you have the tendency of executing the entrepreneurship and so on. And then in this, the next point is research and development. As I told you, that is R&D. It is amalgamation with the economic and social needs of the surroundings of the university. I told you, the university, which does not mean that the university, but also the institutions, the educational institutions, or else the, what should I say, the colleges and so on. Yes, that's the point I would like to tell you. And then contracted and collaborative research. Collaborative research can be had with the government, industry, and communities. Okay, only then you are able to become a successful entrepreneur. Okay, and then apply university knowledge to the regional development. As I told you earlier, it's some students, they may not have how to become an entrepreneur. Okay, how to become an entrepreneur? It just seek for the needs of the people, needs of the people in a particular region. You start with your own region. Okay, you become a business person. You start your business, a small scale industry with the small region. You just study and do the research. And what kind of people are living, whether the people are living in the ethnic group, okay, ethnic group in the sense the people, those who are having the same idea, okay, the same idea, the same consumption, the same concepts and so on. So how they are consuming the product, according to the product, how you are going to use your own innovation and then the technology. So that's the point, that's very, very important point to become an entrepreneur, okay, in the society. And then, as I told you, technological and social services in many areas of knowledge. So you must have that, okay, social services must be there. So that's why we have the ethical values, okay, ethical concepts and the ethical values and so on. Then portfolio, yes, competencies, competence of acquisition. Okay, how do you acquire the competence? Comprehension the integration, comprehension, integration, and application and practical thinking, analyzing, and the problem solving. No, for these, I need one more session to give this design and project and teamwork, and how the leadership skills must be there, and how teamwork can be there, and the ethical, environmental, and professional responsibilities. Okay, then effective communication, and then critical thinking. So for this critical thinking, there are number of books we find that, especially that critical thinking can be termed in different way, that is the lateral thinking. In the lateral thinking, you find the Edward D. Bonus books. Okay, Edward D. Bonus books, you read some of the concepts which are very, very different. Okay, and then knowledge of compulsory issues and lifelong learning. It's very important thing is the lifelong learning. And NEC also insists to have this lifelong learning. In this outcomes-based education also, you have the lifelong learning in your website, lifelong learning. The concept can be put as a separate tab on your website. And on this particular tab, you can give some type of skills and the entrepreneurial concepts and regular updation about the entrepreneurial concepts like that. Okay. And then the planning and management, managing the time. Time management is very, very essential. Okay. and then specific instruments you need. Okay, if you have the traditional instruments to develop your business organization, definitely it will be failure. Okay, you just use that specific instruments according to the social needs and the people's needs. And strategies for the students, how the globalization, okay, you should aware of the globalization, and then how global people want and what are the goods they want to consume, they want to have in your life globally. And digitization, you find that nowadays everything is digitization. Say for example, if you want to send a 1 rupee, you can send 1 rupee to a person. Okay, in a bank you cannot go and write a challan to send a 1 rupee. Okay, definitely the manager will scold you. Okay, but whereas 1 rupee you can send to your friend through there are so many platforms. Okay, digital money transferring platforms, you find that that platforms also they start with what should I say, some sort of a small scale industry like that. Okay, by having the entrepreneurial skills and so on, they have read and they have analyzed the minds of the people, and then everywhere you find that the QR code everywhere, even if a person who the vegetable vendor, okay, on the roadside, the vegetable vendor has the QR code. Okay, and then you just buy 1 kg brinjal, and then you scan, and then you pay the money for 30 rupees or 40 rupees. That's all. He said, okay, sir, it's credited. You just say that the strategy, it is a digitization. How your idea, the entrepreneurial skills can be used through the digitization. So that is very, very important point here. And then communitization. Okay, communitization, I mean, it's a kind of a communication also. And then politicization, it is also sometimes used for the competition. I mean, the competition. Here it is not that politicization, which does not mean that you are going to do the politics, you are involving the politics and so on. But it is the competition, you find that. Okay, and then you find guides and activities. Clarify about your developing deep understanding of the problem. Okay, first of all, what problem takes place if your product is not sold? Okay, if other products are not sold, because you are going to take care of that product by using your own the entrepreneurial skills and using the technology. Okay, and then ideate, you know that it's a discovery of research, and then generate ideas, and then develop, okay, prototypes or to test. Prototypes in the sense, you are the first person to develop. And then you find that in India also, they dared to fly the people, and the 14 companies, IIT Kanpur's incubation center, okay, one belongs to the woman called Abbas. You find that these are all the women entrepreneurs. The women entrepreneurs, it is no entrepreneurs are not only the male, but also the female entrepreneurs, they have achieved more and more. Okay, they have so many opportunities. Since your college is a women's college, exclusively for women's college, you can develop more entrepreneurial skills and so on. So why do you think that you want to work under somebody else? Okay, you just provide a job to others. Okay, under your headship, under your leadership, under your aegis, okay, the more number of people can work, you can give salary to them. Okay, that kind of thing, you must have that. So this is the thing. Then skills, no, knowing, doing, being, taxonomy. Knowing, doing, being, taxonomy. In this classification, this taxonomy, you find how to do, you know, okay, and then doing, what are the doing aspects, and then being, existing. These are very important things. Then 6 powerful entrepreneurial skills. Find the gap, okay, find the gap in the sense, some products are stopped in selling or buying. Why? What is the reason? Is there any generation gap? If it is a generation gap, you can revitalize, okay, revitalize, and then you can give life to that particular product again through your entrepreneurial skills, through the technology and so on. Yes, it's a driver for daylight, how a driver should have the long vision like an eagle, no? So that kind of thing, and fly the OODA loop and then fail wisely. Fail wisely, it's a very important point. When you fail, then you understand why we are failing. What are the reasons for our failures? Then you learn from the failures. And then networks of minds and give the small goods for your workers. I'm talking about your workers. Okay. And then knowledge of the business in general, knowledge of business risks in general, and knowledge of opportunities for development, knowledge of specific risks. But these kinds of things you must know, that as a student you are going to begin your entrepreneurship and your business and so on. The ethnic group, no? Yes, that kind of thing. And the reasons for the entrepreneur's failures. What are the reasons? Vasper says has identified the following reasons. The lack of viable concept. The very important concept is lacking. The lack of market knowledge, lack of technical skills, lack of seeds, capital. Okay, seed capital, you know that it is a kind of a beginning. At the beginning, you are going to spend money. Okay, spend money, recurring head or non-recurring head like that. And then lack of business, know-how in the sense how to do it. And then competency, lack of motivation, social stigma. It is a very, very important thing. Many people, they have this social stigma. So avoid this social stigma. I have erased this one, social stigma. If I begin this particular business or some sort of thing, what about the others? They will think something bad about me. They will think something ill of me. That kind of social stigma you should not have. You are not going to steal or you are not going to do anything illegal activities. But you are going to do the services for the people, for the society, by having your product to be sold, okay, like that. So that's why I tell you that you should not have that social stigma. And then legal constraints and regulations, monopoly and protectionism. Monopoly, okay. So monopolies, it's there everywhere. Everywhere it's there. They have a patent right and they have copyright. They have trademark, TM, no? Trademark, and then they have registered their company. They should not use that kind of word or a symbol like that. It is somewhat a very, very important thing. Okay, so that's why once you begin your business, when the business becomes very, very active, you just have the protectionism. Okay, you just go and register yourself, and then inhibitions, due patents. So these are all the causes for the failures for the entrepreneurs. So with this, I complete today's session. So thank you very much for having given this wonderful.
Oh, thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for your wonderful presentation, your experience on entrepreneurship and innovation. So with this, I request Chetana Kela from Department of Self-Learning. Please propose the vote of thanks for this national level workshop on entrepreneurship and innovation. Over to you, Chetana. Chetana?
For this opportunity. Good afternoon to all. As all good things come to an end in life, so is this workshop. Now it is the time to convey our gratitude to all who have extended their support to make this workshop successful. So on behalf of Institutions Innovation Council and Department of Commerce of Srimati Radhadevi Goenka College for Women Akola, Maharashtra, I Chetana Kela take this opportunity to propose vote of thanks to those who have directly and indirectly contributed to this online workshop on entrepreneurship and innovation as career opportunity. It is rightly said that feeling gratitude and not expressing it is just like wrapping a gift for someone and not giving it to them. In belief of this, at the outset, I would like to thank our Honorable President of Bharatiya Seva Sadan and Institutions Innovation Council, Mr. Dilip Raji Goenka, sir, for his exceptional leadership and motivation. Thank you, sir. At Text, we are thankful to our Honorable Principal, sir, Dr. Devendra Vyasji, sir, for his enthusiastic support and guidance. Thank you, sir. Following with a bunch of thanks to our chief guest and resource person of this national workshop, Honorable Dr. S. Veeramaniji, sir, we owe you one, sir. You have thrown a light on entrepreneurship and innovation as our strengths, as our career, as a development for our nation. Thank you, sir, for teaching us by your heart. Thank you, sir, for this beautiful presentation. Thank you, sir, for showing, for touching so many points in just one go. Thanks a million, sir. I humbly thank to our Honorable Vice Principal, sir, and Head of Department of Commerce, Dr. Ambadasji Pandey, sir, for being with us always, for his guidance throughout this workshop. Let me express my sincere thanks to the Convener of Institutions Innovation Council, Dr. Rupa Gupta, ma'am, for her guidance, selfless hard work, and dedication. The most important appreciation goes to all the faculty members, research scholars, teaching fraternity, students, and all other participants for their active participation and attentive listening. You all are the best. Though and last, but a special thanks to all the faculty members of Institutions Innovation Council and Department of Commerce, our technical team, non-teaching staff, and my colleagues for their unflinching support and coordination. With these warm words, end of today's workshop. Thank you everyone once again. Good day and take care.
Once again, thank you, sir, on behalf of Srimati Radhadevi Goenka College for Women, Akola, Maharashtra. So definitely we will further meet on your next session on project methodology or design, as you said, okay. And communication. Definitely, sir, we will again meet. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Sir. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you for your kind cooperation.
Thank you, sir. My cooperation will be always to you.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. It's a goodness, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Dear participant, I think we have shared a feedback link in the chat box. Please fill the feedback form. As soon as you will fill the form, you will get certificate.
Thank you, ma'am.
अच्छा हुआ रूपा मैडम.
यस सर, आपका कॉर्पोरेट
वेल ऑर्गेनाइज्ड, गुड. अच्छा रहा, पार्टिसिपेंट भी अच्छे थे. ठीक है मैडम.
यस सर.
सर्टिफिकेट का देखा है?
नहीं, आई थिंक फीडबैक फॉर्म शेयर हो गया, सर्टिफिकेट इज आल्सो रेडी. Thank you. बहुत अच्छा हुआ रूपा मैडम.
थैंक यू सो मच.
फीडबैक लिंक भी भर दे. अच्छा किया बच्चों ने दोनों भी.
थैंक यू मैम.
ओके. छान झालं, बहुत अच्छा हुआ. थैंक यू मैडम. ओके.
Very nice.
Sir, your voice is breaking. Rahul sir, your voice is breaking.